We are looking at how creativity and technology overlap and influence each other. We want to showcase and explore what's possible at the intersection of creativity and technology across all types of entertainment in films, animation, games, and beyond. How emerging technologies inspire creators and how they spark new form of entertainment.
The push for creative exploration in feature and visual effects projects has challenged Sony Pictures Imageworks' team of creative and technical artists throughout its 30-plus year history. From elaborate concept designs to loose sketches on a napkin, those initial conversations offer the truest form of creative expression and vulnerability. And it's a powerful and thrilling period of any project where the creative is pulling back the curtain on the story and the visual expectations of the film. And in the moments creators, I want this pitch, we often hear the yearning for something unique.
The history of the God of War franchise at Santa Monica Studio has always been about pushing technology to realize an innovative creative vision. When we reimagined God of War in 2018, we strove to evolve how games deliver narrative storytelling. For God of War in 2018, our creative director, Corey Barlog's vision was to shoot the entire game in one shot. The single shot narrative delivery in God of War 2018 was transformative for storytelling in games and for our franchise. It became a key component of how the narrative story is told and experienced by players.
今日は私たちの会社であるPolyphonyデジタルの制作の哲学とグランツーリスモシリーズのリアリティの源泉、そのプロセスについてお話ししたいと思います。Kazunori-san's
vision was to make an ultra-realistic game that uses some of the same skills and techniques as real race car drivers, making it the closest possible simulation to driving on a real racetrack.
We were determined to keep pushing the industry forward when we embarked on a follow-up, God of War Ragnarok. We asked, how do we evolve our cinematic storytelling to push the envelope even further while building on the innovation of the no-cut camera approach? Continuing our intimate documentary-style camera work, our team was able to create custom buttons on the virtual camera, allowing the camera operator to select lenses and to trigger environmental prop movement directly from the camera. We were also able to allow for a virtual offset of the operator, so that if a scene was happening in a tight or a crowded space, the operator could be standing to the outside, and the camera would still appear as if it was in the middle of the action.
30 years ago, robotics wasn't where it is today. And this is me 30 years ago, so well, anyway. We didn't think that you could build a robotic system that could effectively carry out precise tasks in an open and unstructured environment and guarantee that the robot would do this and that. But we did think that we could create a robot that people could play with it and make people happy.
When Phil Lord and Chris Miller pitched to us this idea of making an animated Spider-Man movie, but not just any animated Spider-Man movie, they wanted a movie that felt like it was ripped directly from the pages of a comic book. And at Imageworks, we had labored for decades to try and master the art of creating characters and environments that were uniquely stylized, but never at this scale, diversity, and never across an entire film.
どう客観すれば量質なデータが得られるか、そのデータから自然をどうモデリングするか、どう効率よく計算するのか、いつだって計算資源って有限ですから、その有限の計算資源から最終的にどうやって最も効果的な表現を得るのか、それらすべてのステージにおいて必要なテクノロジー、そしてクリエイターをその内部に持っているということが、ソニーの強みなのではないかと僕は考えています。Here,
this is the iMac 500 mounted on the Raspberry. And this is the compact and a versatile module for anyone to play with and come up with a range of applications of all kinds. Our unique intelligent vision sensor, IMX 500, is equipped with the on-chip edge-side image processing capability to enable creative solutions. Understanding the real world through the advanced vision system opens a new avenue for all innovations. We also developed a new integrated computing platform to augment our vision sensing technology. It's called Atorius. And I think one of the things Sony can offer to the creators community is a range of technology, from the sensors to motion capture to production capability in the virtual space. When those technologies are combined, they'll reinforce each other, and they'll bring new possibilities to all kinds of creators. Well, I believe that data and computing power will play an essential role in next generation creativity and entertainment as well. They'll help creators to fully realize their visions. And because Sony is the side of creators, whenever we explore a new technology, our priority is to make sure they empower creativity in an ethical and responsible way. That will never change. We must enable more people to access the better creative tools.
For this film, we wanted to avoid CGI as much as possible. We needed to capture the real heat, speed, and danger of racing. We wanted to take the race car movie to a whole new level.
We took player feedback on our 2018 game to heart, and God of War Ragnarok shipped with over 70 accessibility features.
And it is through this process of exploration and discovery, working alongside our talented software teams, brilliant artists, and demanding creative partners, that the spontaneous mix of art and technology is blended together. Films like Across the Spider-Verse challenge the assumptions of what is possible, push our technical capacity, and ultimately answer the creative yearning for something new, unique, and never seen before.
And I hope you've been able to demonstrate, you know, Sony's commitment to build the technology that helps to realize your creative visions. We are here for creators. We are here for creators.